Very good evening to everyone. We are here with yet another session. Today we are here with Dr. Suhas B. He has completed his BNYS and he is undergoing MD clinical naturopathy. He has finished diploma in bioenergy and holistic sciences. He has also finished diploma in child psychology, diploma in counseling and life skills, and fellowship in clinical nutrition. He has worked in different specialization, include plant-based diets, and there are different training programs, skincare regimes, and various yoga sessions for conducting anxiety, schizophrenia, depression, and so many mental health and neurological disorders. With his extensive knowledge and experience, he is dedicated to his client service, his private service, and customized tailor-made diet planning for male and female, fertility, pregnancy, hypothyroid, NCDs, and many more things. With this small introduction, I would like to welcome you on our platform. Thank you so much, Suhas, to come and join with us.
Thank you for this opportunity to talk with the budding naturopaths. Your platform is going good. A big thumbs up for you, because in naturopathy, like, we have to get awareness for the budding naturopathy, especially because people are ending up with some other destination or some other profession, not other than the naturopathy thing. So this through this platform, I think you can really helping the people who are now studying naturopathy, and those who are thinking about naturopathy, they can take this opportunity and they can take the advices from the eminent people who are coming in these sessions. So thank you for this opportunity.
So we'll begin our question.
First and foremost, I should say we are the naturopaths. We have one of the most difficult duty as a human being to listen to the voices of the voices of the those who are suffering, the voices of those who are suffering in their mental issues or in their physical issues or in their psychosocial issues or in their environmental factors where they are suffering a lot. As our treatment is a patient-centered approach to holistic consultation, where it involves emotional health, mental health, spiritual health, physical health, and environmental factors. So to promote the well-being through these aspects, a person, mainly we should undergo the whole characteristics of the person, you know, rather than the symptomatic relief. So to enhance the best way of treating is patient-centered. First and foremost, a practitioner or naturopath should undergo his clients or his patients detailed history, not only the physical history where they are coming up with for us, not only that, only the physical history or they are having some issues, although their mental well-being, how is their lifestyle, all the things may plays an important role in building the relationship, a therapeutic relationship between a doctor and the client or a patient. Because that a therapeutic relationship of rapport or empathy or authenticity to serve the patient's choice and engender the healing process. So essentially, the component of this therapeutic relationship is ability to listen, especially mainly nowadays people are like, they are, especially the naturopaths, I'll say, we are like just influenced by the allopathy or the modern diagnosis techniques. Although I'm not telling it is bad, but still we should always have the grip in our roots, because as we have both traditional and evidence-based techniques, so we should always use in our clinical day-to-day activities, day-to-day activities setup. So usually naturopaths, what they will do, they'll just take the present history and the complaints what they're having and start treating them symptomatically, the relief. It's okay, fine, but still we should know the hidden illness or the hidden element which is there in the person, and we can give the effective treatment and planning about the same thing. So one more thing, naturopaths, usually they will not give time to patient to tell their problem exactly. For example, people may come as an insomnia, for example, I'm giving, We start asking about the insomnia itself. No, we should not ask directly insomnia itself. We should always make them a stable mindset. Then only we can get to know why insomnia is caused, why, whether it is because of the emotional thing or the mental thing, or if they are having any physical elements or any environmental issues. For example, if they are working somewhere, we should ask their how their workplace is, whether the stress is causing them a sleep or not. And then next, what I want to say is the risk factors. For example, we should see the for example, insomnia, it's not just directly the insomnia is caused. There will be some comorbidities along with that. Especially there is a not satisfied life. So for a longer duration of time, people are not satisfied with their life. Just they are living a mechanical life means even then also they will feel that what to say, that imbalance in their life. So that's why we naturopath, especially when we are doing holistic consultation, we have to see all the domains of health, especially from the starting with the physical, mental, moral, social and spiritual, and even emotional status of the health. So that first and foremost, the practitioner, we, the naturopathic practitioner, we should have the ability to and listen, and we have should have a patience and where to stop and where not to stop. That is one of the important thing where patient will be keep on telling, even we have our own limitations, the time limit, everything, but still where to stop and where not to stop we should know, because sometimes the lifestyle history plays an important role in some of the conditions. In some conditions the lifestyle histories may not concern more. So we should know that where we have to stop and where we have to make them patient realize is self skills. For example, we should not impose him for some of the techniques. What we have in naturopathy, we have many many techniques like hydrotherapy, naturopathy, in naturopathy we have diet, fasting and all. Although we have the techniques, it is not that you should not impose the things with a person where he is not liking it. So we should analyze his attitude, his mental status, then only we can able to plan the treatment accordingly. So that is one more thing I want to tell you. And in holistic consultations, what we have to do, especially we have to explore the range of problems, the problem where it is, like whether it is a physical problem or a mental problem, and we have to identify and reveal the patient to describe whether, for example, a back pain may not be concerned with the only physical exhaustion, although it will be because of the mental exhaustion where a person is not having a better sleep, not having a proper food. Because of not having proper food, he may get constipated. Even constipation is also leads to lower back pain. So this is all the multiple complex issues where a person will be going through. We should see each and everything. It's not just okay, lower back pain, okay, chalo, we'll start with the treatment. No, we should see and we should analyze everything, even the relationship with the family members, how he is behaving, how he is leading the life every day, whether he is feeling anything, discomfort or any unsatisfied things are going on, whether the work which he is doing, whether it is liking or it is just for the sake of money is doing. We should see each and everything and we should start counseling him from the day one itself. Because I know, I understand some people will not open up in the first session itself, but still we should always have that approach towards them, so they will feel that okay, the person, like they will feel comfortable where I can talk like that. Because I understand, because the mental issues nowadays, it's becoming like a normal thing, but still we should not neglect it. So whichever the problem may be, mental issues, like whether they are suffering from that issues, whether it is only physically or mentally or emotionally, whether or any domains of the health, we should see and we should check, and then only we should go forward to analyze the problem. without knowing the domain, which domain has been concerning, or which domain it is being very what to say, elevating the symptoms, and we should see, and then we should go for the further thing. So next we can go after analyzing everything, every parameters, everything, whether the physical thing, the recent reports, everything. And there should be empathy towards the patient, where there will be some sensitive things, for example, infertility or some male genital or female genital problems. We should see how the health is going on well from the past, for example, from the childhood, how they are, whether they are, have a proper lifestyle in from the childhood, how their house, how their family, how their family members, and their stage by stage, how they are doing in their academics and in their life, and about the relationship between friends, relatives, and even family members, that will also play a major role. So then after analyzing this, the holistic perspective will go forwards towards understanding the problem and focusing the exact problem, or what to say, the element which the patient is experiencing the problems. So naturopath facilitation skills should help the patient accurately focus on symptoms, while also using the naturopathy clinical skills, and even with the help of the modern diagnosis also. So regarding the acute cause happening. Yes. And one more thing, nowadays people, I feel integration with other system will also help the patients to relieve and recover very soon. So I feel as a naturopath, we should be open and flexible with the other system of medicine, whether it is allopathy or with the other allied health sciences, because our main goal is to cure the patient and should lead a proper sustainable life. So I feel we should be always have a open-minded to flexible, that whether my treatments are the treatment plan and the modalities which I'm giving for the patient, whether it is sufficient or he need any other alternative supplements or alternative medicines along with my modalities. We should see that after understanding the problem of the patient, and then only we can put forward that. And we should not fear, make them, okay, you should be always in some sort of naturopathy itself. No, it is, if the condition is demanding some of the integration with other system of medicine, it is good that we are referring and we are seeking the help of this some other health professionals also. It is ultimately a patient should get a proper recovery. That's it. So other than that, what I feel in holistic consultation is setting goals. For example, yoga, nowadays people are aware of yoga, but still few people are not liking it. So that we should not impose the yoga for the condition. We should always have a alternative modalities, alternate modalities where we can switch to the other therapies. For example, exercise therapy, and for example, some stretching therapy other than the yoga, or we can modify the things which is there in yoga according to the evidence based and even with the traditional touch. So we can able to modify the things according to the patient's comfortability, so that we can easily start implementing the treatments or intervention to the patients without disturbing their mental health. Because usually what happens, some people are not comfortable with some of the things, fine, but still that's why naturopathy plays an important role, where we are treating them in a patient-centered approach, so that we have each and every individual has its own tailor-made modalities, so that through this patients can improve their health, and even specific time according to the organ clock, and according to the Panchamabhutas, according to the panchakoshas in yoga. So we have to prepare a time where the modalities can be used, and the effect of that modality or the intervention will be attained at most in the patients. So before that, we should ask with the patient, and we should tell and we should discuss regarding the treatments, where how we are giving, this is the thing and this is how to do. Because so many patients, like some people are, they are aware of some naturopathy and yoga things, but still they have the doubts in that. So because they have gone through several professionals and several advisors, so that they will feel some doubt before starting the treatment. So we should be always clear-minded, and we should always have a flexible discussion with the patient, so that he will take the treatments without any self-doubt. So this is regarding that. And next, in a holistic consultation, we'll go for the treatment. Especially, we should always not to see the particular element. Rather than, we should always see the see to increase the vitality of the person. Because as our naturopathy principle, based on the vitality, the improving the vitality, attaining the maximum level of health, only through a better gaining vitality. So I will feel to encourage the patient to self-motivate and developing the maintaining the self-realization of the body and mind. So once we are connecting both body and mind, so the treatment modalities will go further. So the potential barriers will be anticipated by assessing and discussion and contagion. For example, what happens, we can use in an OPD basis, we can use questionnaires for our quality of life, because in a single session we are unable to know what is exactly what is happening in a particular person. So through questionnaires, we'll analyze whether the person is undergoing which stage of elements or which phase of inflammation. So through the several questionnaires are there, whether it is a physical element or a mental element, so many questionnaires are there, so many inventories are there, we can use that, so that patient will also feel some confidence about our system. Because so many people yet to try the naturopathy and yoga. So for these cases, usually for the naturopaths who are newly started their practice, they usually feel some hesitation and some problems while considering the problem. The problem means the case which is necessary in the patients. So make sure that these assessments will help you out to conclude the diagnosis, so that the naturopaths can plan a better treatment protocols. So, and one more thing, patient skills independence should be there towards the treatment. Naturopathy role, as a naturopath, we always set a goal for the patient, where, for example, a weight loss journey, for example, a person, you have to lose around 10 to 15 kgs. In a one shot, a patient can't lose it. But ensure that we should have a constant motivation for the patient. They should understand, and it should be a plan. A patient plan should be independent, and it should be comfortable for the patient itself. It is not that it is my plan, so I'm planning something alone. If I plan, it won't work properly, because we should ask the proper necessary things and comfortable aspect, the comfortable zone of the patient. And then only we have to execute the plans. Then only we can easily progress and achieve the goals in an easy way, in an easier way. And even it is very essential for to reach the particular results. Usually what happens, naturopaths, what they will do, like I'll just give a flow chart where the new, a current, a new after internship people, the graduates, they'll start with the treatment or the clinical practice. They will just take the learned protocols. Just they'll take the learned protocols to treat the disease or a syndrome. But after that, soon after that, after doing, the naturopath will involve in the another stage where he will choose that one size fit for all approach, which means the naturopathic philosophy and the evidence-based protocol, he try to merge together, and he want to give the treatment. So other than that, the competent naturopaths, like after getting some experience in the clinical things, they will start developing their own protocols and their own independent strategies according to the patient's comfortability. And after that, we start digging the literature review, the traditional learning and evidence-based practice. We'll try to intuitive treatments for the patient to best align the conditions. For example, in autoimmune diseases, we have to take the help of the both traditional and even the evidence-based modalities. And after that, after some sort of experience from the clinical things, the patient will getting the proper treatments. Naturopaths will start analyzing each and every aspect in the patient's life. Because, for example, what happens? A patient is physically ill, and he will come to the clinic, and he'll have that proper rapport. The naturopathy will start having the better rapport with the patients, and start discussing about the sensitive issues where a person is undergoing. So because of that, as I mentioned before, the particular therapeutic relationship should be there between the doctor and the patient. So for that, we should have a proper rapport, and slowly, slowly we can reveal, the person can reveal, the patient can reveal the sensitive things which is happening in his life for longer duration. This is about the holistic consultation where we have to do. And even I can explain you now regarding the holistic assessments, where we have to see the location of the condition, where it is, whether it is anatomical, it is certain effects in the anatomical or physiological, or be aware with the conditions where multiple locations will be there. For example, arthritis or systemic lupus erythematosus, so on. So then, and next we have to go for the onset, where the problem started and where the trigger of the problem occurred, the factors and the manner which is started, whether it is fluctuating or whether it is a long problem, or the patient, sometimes the patient will neglect some minor issues. So from there, it start risking the patient with a higher chronic conditions. And the course of the duration, the course of the problem, whether it is onset is prolonged and it is continuous, or it is intermediate, or it is occasionally, for example, twice a week or twice a year, some fluctuating constant fluctuating dates or some pains we have to look after. And then we'll go for the duration where the problem is started and whether it is fluctuating, how long the episode of the problem endures, or if it is intermittent. And next we'll go for the sensation or the quality, whether the five senses of feeling, like ache, burn, numbness, pinch, or stabbing, or throbbing, or hot, cold, anxious, sad, dizziness, or nauseous, or twisting, tingling sensation, or in the side, the color, consistency, structure, shape, all those things, and even sound, for example, the crepitations of the joints, rattling sound, gasping sound, rumbling, boozing, and even odor, the ketosis or fishy, yeasty or sharp odors in the mouth, or in the inflammation where we are getting, and in the intestine where we feel some odor in the feces, or those things we have to look after while taking the present history. And even taste, a person is feeling, all of a sudden the person says, I'm feeling bitter. If I have anything also, I feel bitter, salty, or some metallic taste sensations also. And even the loss of any sensation is also clinically significant. Make sure that we are doing the same. And intensity, how the problem is going, whether it is in the acute, mild, moderate, or severe. Because in acute conditions, it will be mild, but gradually it will go to moderate and to the severe. Make sure that we should give a patient a score out of 10, how much number you can give a range for your problem, so that for our follow-ups, the revisits of the patients will be very helpful. And even regarding the modalities, like whether they have taken any medications, like previous medications or any so-called home remedies or something for that same condition, we should ask them. And even whether which time the condition or the problem or the pain getting worse, whether in the time of the day, week or seasons, or in any particular year it has again triggered the situation, such as in bed going to sleep that time, or in the workplace, or during hot weather or cold weather, certain activities may trigger. So certain emotions or spiritual crisis also, for example, headache, usually it also involves a major role in the mental health also, where they are working, whether the relationship between the person, the colleagues or the family members, that will also trigger the problem even more worse. So radiation, the radiates, whether the pain is radiating to the other location or shifting the pain, we should always ask these things. It is a place and made major role. And concomitants. Concomitants, usually what happens, for example, the problem occurs, is there any other part of the person, for example, loss of appetite with the depression, and headaches with the existential crisis, or irritability with the hot flushes, like that, so on, so many problems which is occurs, and there will be other symptoms in the other part of the body which is not related directly. And even past history, in an acute case, this can be a previous history of the presenting complaint. It is also like it's a general thing where the issues of the patient's issues of the day-to-day activities, or from the before 3 months or 1 year of their period. And even family history, it's more important, where we can analyze the general history of all the health issues of the family. As you know, nowadays the lifestyle disorders is also linked with the genetics. Nowadays the genetic role plays very more in the people who are suffering from diabetes, hypertension, or any cardiovascular conditions. And even medications, usually, especially people self, by googling it, some of the conditions, if the symptoms is there, they will start googling it and they'll take their own prescription, and they'll take paracetamol as a snack each and every time if they feel ill. If they have just fever, the cold or cough, they'll start taking paracetamol. So we have to check whether there will be a drug induced effect or overdose of the effect. Some effects will be there. It will be occurring for a longer duration of time because of the overuse of the drugs. So that is one more thing. And diet, usually what type of diet they are using. The comprehensive diet of naturopathy is, we treat a patient and we cure the condition. It is not the final part. So that a person who cured by his condition, he should lead a proper sustainable life. For that, diet plays an important role. So we should see their diet, and every week we should analyze their diet, whether their diet is going well or not. Because some people, what they will do, they will come for the naturopathy modalities, they'll take the intervention. After that, when they're going home, they'll start using their own diet. They'll fly out all the things, whatever they have learned in the naturopathy and yoga setup, and everything they will forget, and they'll start doing. They feel like, so my weight is now reduced, my elements are going to be controlled, so I can eat whatever I want. No, the sustainable food should be there till you live. For the lifetime, you should always use the thing. Because 1 or 2 days you can have a cheat day, but it should not go further than that. Because people they feel that, okay, I'm done. So make sure that the naturopaths should prepare a diet where they should not too much of imposing the tough diet initial time, because they should analyze what is happening in their body. If they have this type of diet, what is the complications they have observed. So now I'm giving a proper some particular diet where the patient can relieve their symptoms eventually. So we should start giving awareness about the diet, tell them to check and tell them to try for a week. Then only if they are getting a self experience, then only they'll come to know the exact value of the diet. So, and even a timeline, usually what happens, the case taking timeline I'm talking, the single case issues may be long last for 15 to 20 minutes, but for some conditions where it is lifestyle disorder or it is autoimmune disease, first they should understand what is happening in their body, because we should explain in a layman language where what is happening in the body, in which stage the person is in now. So make sure that we are telling that first, and so that the treatment modalities according to that we can plan, because ultimately patient should understand, patient should realize what is exactly happening in my body, so what I have to do now, so that we can set up our treatment goals and even our remedy preparations, and we can lead a proper prognosis. So that is one more thing. And even sometimes what happens in first session only we are unable to take. For example, some of the people who are not aware of anything. For example, nowadays people are learning about the conditions. They are aware of their health, but still some people are not. So that we should not impose everything in a single day, so that they will not take anything, any message for the home. So first session only we should not impose each and everything, each and every treatment modalities, or about the condition, what they are suffering, or about the fees. Everything will matters, because the setup which is there, we should have a proper financial thing also, so that we should have economically and budget friendly also, so that people start believing first. Then we can start giving a proper protocol. So for that reason, even for the mental conditions where people are deprived or depressed in some sort of relationship breakups or anything, in first session only they were unable to explain, they are unable to reveal or unable to open up in a first session itself. So make sure that we are giving multiple sessions with a proper minimum, a little gap in between, so that they will not lose that touch of the naturopathy intervention, about the rapport with the doctor, so that they will not feel even the heavy, the pressure won't be there, that in a single day we are taking too much of time of them. So it is not a good idea where we can't analyze the deep hidden element which is present in the patient. So as I was saying, holistic review should be there. For example, as I said, as I explained before, a past history, family history, lifestyle history, and cognitive history, emotional history, and spiritual history, and even about the body systems, it's play an important role in understanding the problem and even for the setting the goal. For example, some people, I'll be very open, so some people will not chant some of the mantras because they feel it is religious. It's okay, fine, but we should understand where their level of knowledge about the spiritual thing. So once we are understanding the spiritual thing, the people will start understanding, okay, this is not just a religious thing, it is having a scientific approach, the Akara, Ukara, or Gayatri mantra, or some of the scientific mantras in Hatha Yoga or Garanda Samhita, which is prescribed, they will understand, and even for our assessment of the holistic thing will also help. That is one more thing I want to explain you, and regarding the past history I have told, family history I have told, lifestyle history, especially we should ask them their level, the status of lifestyle, whether they are doing exercise or if they are doing any fitness regime, at least just a walk, or they are doing any sort of coordination movements, mobility, flexibility, strength, stamina, aerobic capacities. We should always check that, because a person nowadays, people are lack of exercise, their lung capacity is decreased. Without knowing that, if they start giving the pranayama, if they start doing some of the yoga, they may not attain and they may not get the particular effect beginning itself. So what happens, we may say them to do, if they will do, but after that, if they are not getting a particular results, they feel naturopathy and yoga, they will lose the confidence in naturopathy and yoga. So before that, we should ask their stamina, we should check their strength is spirometry, the portable spirometry will be there, ask them to blow and check, because most of the obesity patients, they have this expiration level will be very low. So make sure that check them, and according to that, we can plan the treatments. And even regarding their lifestyle, their life, especially where their recreation, entertainment, rest, and holidays, whether they are going frequent holidays or outstation or staycation or something, and even alcohol consumption, coffee, tea consumption, smoking, and even some of the drugs without knowing, some people they have given. Nowadays, I have seen drugs are implementing, they are preparing with the normal chocolates. They are telling like a dark chocolate or something, energy boosting chocolates and all. I observed that some of the drug chemical which is present in that chocolate, so that they are getting addicted to that slowly. So, and even daily exposure to the toxins, pollution, like chemicals, for example, their socioeconomic status, where they are staying, whether the place where they are staying, whether it is clean, the drainage is clean, and even the water supply, how they are drinking, like whether the filtered water, hot water, cold water, these things also helpful for us to prepare a proper treatment goals and even understand the exact problem. Even a patient's education is also much more needed, but still it is our duty that we have to explain each and every aspect to about the treatment or the system or the disease at their layman language. And even the work condition, whether they are getting excessive stress, whether it is a physical stress or a mental stress, we should see. And even the home conditions, whether if they are couples, if the husband and wife relationship is good, or the parents relationship is good, or the children, their children education, whether they are doing good in their life, everything will also matters for a particular condition. And even about the socioeconomic, as I said, even the financial status is also play a major role. For example, in a country where nowadays after the COVID, everyone is feeling the scarcity of money, the financial crisis is going very high nowadays. So that is also play an important role. And it come to, and now we'll come for the mind, emotion, and spiritual aspect, where a person is leading a life satisfactorily. Whether you leave the physical thing, till now what I said, you just leave. You just ask the question where you are living happily inside, not just outside. Yeah, because some people they have so many elements inside the emotions which is there, with the piled up emotions in the body, they will not open up. But they will outside, they will be happy, because they want to show the social status very well, so that they will hide the necessary piled up emotions. There is no necessity to hide anything, because what happens, initially we won't feel anything, gradually it will always kill us inside. So we should have, if we don't have a proper relationship with a particular person, go to him, talk to him, and clarify it now and then itself. Then only a proper relationship may be better, or if you are unable to maintain it, you can just cut it off, because it is not there is no mandatory that we should have a proper relationship with each and everyone. No, we are all human beings. We have our own perspectives. We have our own emotions. We have our own intellectual skills, where we will understand the same scenario in a different ways. So, and even the connectedness with our childhood friends, college friends, whether they are doing it well, or the family history with the colleagues or with the community, society, because nowadays people are not talking with their neighbors. They don't know who is staying in the next house, in the next neighbor, who is staying, like where he will work, those things. They're like everything they have lived. They left everything, and they are just doing a mechanical job. It is also not satisfied for themselves. For the sake of money, for the sake of maintaining the social status in front of others, they are suppressing themselves both physically, mentally also. That mainly we naturopaths play an important role while counseling them. We want to show them what is exactly the lifestyle or the life or the thing which is why we are born. Because what happens in education time, a patient, parents will stay. okay beta, chalo, you finish this, you will lead a proper life. After 10th, okay, PU. After PU, degree. Degree after master degree. Like that, we are in just in a competition, in a running train. So after that, we should understand, because ultimately, the healthy life or a healthy person also plays an important role in maturity. Maturity is not just an age, it's also the inside cognitive effect where a person can understand. Because for small, small things, getting angry and disturbing the relationship, it is not a proper maturity. Because maturity is where we should analyze the both the perspective, whether it is the person who is front of me and even about me also. We should analyze the perspective and then calmly with the patience, and we have to discuss the issues. Then only we'll get a ultimate solution for that. In spite of the doing that, we'll just taking our ego up in front of our face and start arguing and making a big issue. There will be nothing. We won't get even both of the people, nothing they'll get. So, and even regarding the stress, the grief or the trauma which they are coping in their childhood also, from in the relationship between the parents or anything, any colleagues or friends, anything, and even mood perception, perceptions and sensitivities and motivation will also have an intense drawback in the health issues for a particular person. So as I explained this, the body compositions or the body system, where, for example, I don't want to go deep into the each and every conditions, because people, the naturopaths, they are well trained with the academics, but they don't know how to convey that to the particular person rightfully. For example, what happens in so many wellness centers I have seen, whatever the patients say, they'll just write it down and they'll keep it as a case sheet. So that is not the thing, that is not the right thing, where we should analyze. If there's a proper reports, then only you should diagnose. If there is not, try to check without having any doubt. If we are giving any treatments, then only the results will come very fast. So make sure that a person is having a particular condition. He will say, doctor, I have a cholesterol. No, then we will write dyslipidemia. No, no. We should check once, or we should ask the patient where we have a proper previous reports regarding the health issues. Then only we should conclude the things. So this is regarding the naturopathy thing. And one more terminology I want to introduce, where posology will call posology, that the maybe we have studied a lot of therapies, the duration, the principle of the treatment, I understand, yes. But when we are giving a patient-centered approach for the patient, while giving the patient treatment, while giving the treatment for the patient, we should see their vitality, their immunity. So then only we can able to handle the things. For example, if a person is having a high vitality, its immunity is normal, then we can give a higher dose of treatments. If a person is having a moderate level, then we should modify our treatment also. It is not that, okay, the treatment principle is like this, we should give a hip bath for 20 minutes only. No, there is no rules like that. So according to the patient condition, we have to give. Even 5 minutes of steam is also enough after the massage. It is not that they should take for a 10 to 15 minutes or something like that. No, according to the condition, according to the patient comfortability, we have to prepare, and we have to make sure that the patient is not feeling any discomfort in any step. Example, for example, just taking a abdomen pack. Usually we'll give as a preparatory practice before giving any treatment. We'll start with the abdominal pack. The temperature of the abdominal pack, it may be neutral, but patient may feel cold. So that we should see and we should observe, and we should tell the therapist to observe these minute aspects, so that we can overcome the irritation of the patient, so that patient can take the treatment comfortably. This is the one more thing. And even patients who have a lesser vitality, we can start with a milder treatment. So it is not that we should start everything we have to impose in a single day or in everything. No, we should understand the patient, understanding the problem. And once we are telling the patient regarding their condition, if they are clear with that, so we can start inducing slowly, because slow means people may say, no, people will not go. No, if the patient is believing us, even 2 years of treatments can be given peacefully, because till 2 years we can start giving till 2 years we can give the treatments. Because mainly, first and foremost, patient should understand the naturopathy thing, and even regarding the disease which they are suffering, and then only we can administer, even about the body condition, whether the vitality is lowered or moderate or weakened. We should observe those things, and then we have to start implementing the treatments. So this is what I want to explain regarding the holistic patient-centered approach to holistic consultation. After we, especially what happens in our setup, usually we have our ready-made protocols. We should come out from that. Each and every cases, anything you take, even a single mild fever you take, or any upper respiratory tract diseases you take, come out from that. You have to think out of the box, and you have to think regarding the patient itself. It's not about the system, or it's not about the treatment. It's not about the traditional learning or the traditional principles of the naturopathy or evidence-based. We should analyze the patient first. Patient is the first. We should forget everything. Patient is the first. We should analyze. Then only we'll get a proper understanding regarding the condition, and even patient status. Patient, how he is mentally, how he is stable, and how he is ready to take our treatment. So some people are not comfortable with the Jalaneti, Sutraneti, and Navmi, Basti, and all. So we should not impose them. Oh, you have to take, there is no other way. No, we should analyze them day by day. The person will start understanding our treatment modality. Why we are giving this? Okay, after giving this, okay, this is happening. Then only we can start implementing slowly. So make sure that if we are giving a proper, before giving a proper treatment, analyze the patient, listen to the patient. First and foremost is listening to the patient is the best consult holistic assessment, I say. Because without understanding in depth, we can't able to give the treatment, or we can't able to plan anything further. So after understanding the treatment, we can give a proper understanding the condition, we can give the proper treatment, and we can able to recover. We can able to give a proper recovery as soon as possible. From there, a person or an individual who come for the naturopathy treatment, we can lead a better sustainable life throughout his journey. So by this, I'll conclude my session, conclude my talk. Thank you, Bhavit.
Thank you so much. We had a great detailed discussions on multiple points regarding the assessments, clinical history, and the dietary and clinical management as per se. So we would like to understand then, how do you see in your clinical practice, what kind of patient do you see, and how do you treat them? Do you give them personalized approach or generalized approach?
I'll always starting, as I said, I was, whatever I have said, all my personal experience itself, because no one knows starting, because in our own practices, what happens, we'll be still confused. By the regular practice, we'll start analyzing. Nowadays, like, I'm mainly concentrating on the mental health, whether whatever the physical condition may be, but I will always see the mental health, whether they are happy in their life. Then only whatever I say, they will take. If not, it is like a mechanical thing. Okay, take this. They are taking, they are doing, but still they are not happy with what they are doing. First, we have to go in depth, and they make them to feel free to talk what is happening in their life. For example, the PCOD condition, it is affecting because of the bad relationship with the partner. That will finally lead to infertility. Because what the girls usually, what they are very sensitive, and they are unable to talk properly. Nowadays, a busy life, the partners, the couples, they don't have time to talk. That's why I will talk in these cases. I'll do the relationship counseling. So from that, I can understand the in-depth element which is there present in them, so that I can get a sessions with the both of them if they are comfortable. Then only make sure that I'll understand my principle, how it work in their body, without knowing these things. So from there, I'll give always a customized treatments, customized modalities, and even in a single case, we have multiple struggles. So because what happens, thyroid people have obesity, beginning to start having diabetes also, and even hypertension also. From first, I should choose which one I can have to take, because we have to take the first which is getting out of control. Make sure that which is we are getting it first, and we should take the necessary action or necessary modalities for that. Then only we can slowly treat with them, because hormonal issue, whatever you give up symptomatic relief also, again it will trigger some. So first and foremost, we should go in depth for the hormone reversal, hormonal imbalance. We have to balance it properly. Then only we can able to manage these comorbidities which is coming up because of this reason. And for example, nowadays people having grayish of hair, hair fall, everything. They should analyze where they have got the roots of the condition. 90% of the condition will be because of the hormones. 10% may be because of the genetics. So people are not aware of it, but it is our duty that we should understand them where you are lacking behind. From there, if we are start giving the treatment from the root cause, so that we can able to come up with the greater results, and people will also understand, okay, this is my problem. Okay, this for that reason, this is the symptom. Okay, this is the thing what we have to do. Nowadays, like people, like they're not having patience. I understand they don't have patience. They are running in a faster, that busy life. Still, it is our job that we have to go to their level. We have to understand them at most, how we can understand to their level. Because everyone's education, everyone they doesn't have proper education. They won't understand exactly what is the principle of naturopathy. Some people may experience, and then some people may start studying that and then follow that, but some people may not. But still, we should have that patience to understand their condition, and we should have that rapport with the patient, so that you should not go to some other patient, some other people, because he is not understanding, and he is also, the rapport, if it is not proper, patient will not stand for a longer duration. So that is what I want to say.
So with this, we will conclude our today's session. And I would like to say thank you so much, Dr. Suhas, to come on our platform and deliver such a crisp and kind of insightful talk for all of us, where we can learn so many things from you in terms of clinical approach and how to deliver that clinical services to your clients, to your patients in your personal setting and in a hospital setting. So with that, thank you so much to come on our platform.
Welcome. Thank you for this opportunity. And you're doing a good job where, like, people are getting, I got a feedback from other people also from these platform, this Onion Work platform. Like, people, the budding naturopaths are getting awareness, because our the course which is there, it's like a mechanical course where people just studying, the students are just studying, mugging or something they are doing, and they're finishing the exams and end up with some degree, but they don't know what is exactly naturopathy is, even after spending 5.5 years of time. So these, because of these sessions, people, the students are understanding, and they're analyzing themselves. Okay, this is the naturopathy. Okay, this is what I should do. The thing which is very great that you are doing it, still keep on continuing. I'll always supporting you. And thank you for this opportunity.
Thank you so much for your kind words. Definitely for the community, we'll build some good network and support for all the students. Thank you, Suhas.